Okay, now we are coming to the third and the last session, that is risk management and position sizing. So let us discuss about the risk management, position sizing. We already discussed concept, swing trading concept in the first session. Second session, we discussed about the swing trading strategies. Now let us discuss about the risk management and position sizing. Now first one, let us start with how to trail the stop loss in swing trading. Swing trading, especially, you should know how to trail the stop loss, because unlike day trading, time is on your side. In swing trading, you have time. Day trading, you don't have time because market is open only from 9:15 to 3:30. Swing trading, you can hold on to your position for next day, next week. Even you can hold on to your position up to the last Thursday of the month if you are trading in future or option, or if you are trading in delivery in the cash, you can even hold on to your position for the months. No one will ask you, right? Because you have taken the delivery. So you can hold on to your position even for months. That is why you should know how to trail the stop loss in swing trade. That is what I'm going to discuss here. How you can make your winners big by trailing your stop loss. There are three methods to trail stop loss in swing trading. One of the method is previous candle high-low method. It can work well during parabolic moves due to some news in the stocks. What is the parabolic moves actually? Parabolic moves happens, suppose you assume that some stocks are trading like this, okay? Maybe small up move or down move, whatever it could be. Slowly it is moving. And one fine day, some news comes in the market. Maybe it says some pharmaceutical stocks, and this pharmaceutical stocks got a US FDA for some of that drugs. And you know that this is a positive news for that stocks. Next day you can see candlestick like this. Okay, that is known as parabolic moves. Normally parabolic moves, you see that back to back kind of big green candles. That news will be there for a few days most of the time. And you will see big candles like this. So that is what known as parabolic move. If you take an entry on this candle, then you can use this method. Previous candle, high or low. That means you have taken the entry, right? Maybe you kept your stop loss below the candle. Next day, another green candle, what you can do, remove your stop loss, keep it here, below that candle. Next day, another green candle, remove your stop loss, keep it here. Because parabolic move, sometimes it can keep moving, especially in the stocks, because that stock is in the news. There may be another parabolic move like this. Okay, back to back parabolic move. So what you should do? Keep trailing your stop loss. Every time it forms a candle, you'll keep the stop loss below the candle. That is what known as trailing stop loss with the previous candle high low method. That means once market is closed here, then you'll keep your stop loss here, right? You have kept your stop loss here. Next day, candle opened with a bullish candle. Then your stop loss will, once it is candle closed, you'll keep stop loss here. Next, you see another green candle, you remove your stop loss from the previous candle and you keep it here. That means that is how you keep trailing your stop loss until the candle comes and breaks that. Okay, that is what previous candle high low method. It can be on the downtrend also. Sometimes some bad news also can come in the market with some stocks and it can keep falling like this. In that case, best place is again same previous candle high low method. Mean if you shorted this candle, then next candle it is formed, remove your stop loss from here, keep it here. Previous candle, next candle is formed, again you can keep it here. Another candle is formed, remove your stop loss and keep it here. Next candle forms, remove from the previous candle and keep it below it. Okay, another, if you see a red candle, remove your stop loss from here and keep it here. That is what known as trailing stop loss previous candle high low method. You will remove from the previous candle and you can keep it stop loss below that candle which closed. Whenever finally one candle comes, maybe it makes a bullish candle and breaks that level, now you are out. Now you can book your profit here. That means you entered somewhere here and you booked your profit here. You made a good profit, right? But as I said, it can happen whenever there's talks in some news. That time you can expect some good movement, and it can keep going up or keep going down based on the news. You can apply this method and you can trail the stocks. Then you can apply swing high low method. It can work very well whenever stock is in the trending mode. What is the swing high low method? Swing high method is like this. It's in the strong uptrend, right? Market comes back, makes a pullback. This is called swing lows. Okay, this is called swing lows. So how to trail this stop loss? Suppose you entered the trade here, and once it made a swing low, remove your stop loss, keep it here. Next, it made a swing low, and once it started going up, remove your stop loss, keep it here. Once it made a next swing low, started going up, remove your stop loss, keep it here. Again, it started going up, once made a swing low, remove your stop loss. This is one of the best method where you can make winners big by just following the trend. Suppose you kept your stop loss here below that swing, and then market started coming down, you're out. You're out. That means you're trailing stop loss hit. As long as it is above that previous swing, keep trailing your stop loss. That you can try it, and you can apply moving average method. I'll show you moving average method also, how you can use moving average. And this one works well whenever it's in trending mode. And moving average has to be in sloping mode, like this, sloping, or like this. Moving average, it should never be sideways like this. Okay, it should be always in the sloping mode. Remember that thing. Okay, look at this stock. This is the JSW Steel. Okay, you can see that somewhere here, strong uptrend, right? Strong uptrend. Look at the uptrend. Back to back green candle non-stop. Suppose you entered a long trade here in this stock. Okay, look at the strong uptrend here, right? Back to back green candles. I'm not saying that you have to enter exactly here, nothing like that. Just I'm giving you example this. Okay, suppose you entered this candle, and what you will do, you'll keep the stop loss below the candle, right? Next candle, once it formed, you'll keep it here. Next candle, you kept it. You can see that candle came near the low of that candle, but could not break it, right? Break it mean could not close it. That means you are still in the trade. Candle has to break the previous candle low, then only you are out from that trade. Until and unless, you will not be out. This candle only went below it, but could not close it. Here also you kept it, here also you kept it. It went all the way till the previous candle low, but it bounced. It could not close. Here also, this candle also, this candle, this candle. No candle could break previous candle low, right? That is what based on previous candle high and low. Okay, let me show you a couple of more charts so that you will clearly understand what actually is this previous high low candle method. Look at this stock from here till here. Look at this, such a parabolic move, right? What was the price? I think around 150, around 150. It went up to 320, 325 within, I think, mid-July to almost mid-August. Stock has more than doubled. So how to trail this kind of movement? How you can capture this movement? How you can make your profits big? How you can trail your stop loss and make your profits big? That let me explain it here. For example, if you entered this candle, just an example, if you entered this candle, this small pin bar, this candle you entered, you kept the stop loss below the low of that candle. Then once next candle formed, you kept your stop loss here. You kept your stop loss. You kept your stop loss. Look at this. Look at this. You kept your stop loss. Next candle, wicks came below it but could not close it, right? So that means until next candle breaks the previous candle low, you will not close your position. It's this candle only went below that candle but could not break it. So that means you are still in the trade. This candle also went below the previous candle low but could not break it. Right? Still you are in the trade. You are in the trade. This candle, you can see that, went below it but could not close it. This candle also almost went to the low of the previous candle. This candle almost went to the low of the previous candle, but could not properly close below the previous candle low. Still, you are in the trade. 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 Just see which candle breaks broken the previous candle low, right? This candle broken it. So you entered here. You will book profit here. Okay. Then if you entered again second time, then just look at this. You entered here. If you suppose enter this candle, if you kept your stop loss here, once this candle formed, remove the stop loss, keep it here. Next, you keep it here. Next, keep it here. Keep it here. Keep it here. Then huge candle, next candle, keep it here. Keep it here. This is the candle you book your profit, because you can clearly see that this candle, this red candle, broken the previous candle low, properly broken the previous candle low. So that is how you can trail the stop loss and you can make winners big. Though it is not possible exactly where market can reverse, right? You don't know where it can reverse, but trailing stop loss can help you to capture this kind of winners. Look at this, another stop. If you entered somewhere here, if you entered first trading day of the month, in month of May, first look at this. You kept your stop loss, then kept your stop loss, kept your stop loss. Look at this. No candle could break till here. Only could go below previous candle, but could not break it, right? This candle, look at this, went just at the previous candle low, close near previous candle low, but could not break it, could not break it, could not break it, could not break it, could not break. And this candle properly broken the previous candle low. This candle low was broken here. So suppose you entered here, you could have taken profit here. That is what I say. Whenever in the parabolic move, it works very nicely. Parabolic move means something goes like this. Okay, parabolic moves means something goes like this. And if you again entered at this bullish candle, second time if you entered, look at this. Could not break, could not break, could not break. Here also only wicks went below. Wicks, 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 right? Then wicks only went. It could not break. This also closed almost at the previous candle low. Could not break it. Could not break, could not break. This is the candle finally broken it. This is where you will exit, because you can clearly see that this candle has broken it. That is what known as trailing your stop loss based on previous candle high and low. When you are in the long trade, you will only look for the previous candle low to be broken to book your profit. As long as previous candle low is not broken, you will stay in that trade. Look at this chart. This is where downtrend started with a bearish candle and you kept your stop loss here, right? After that, downtrend started. Look at this. Which candle broken the previous candle high? No candle broken the high of the previous candle, right? No candle could break the previous candle high. Look at this. Look at this. And finally, you can see that this candle, even though it's a small candle, you can see that it went above the previous candle high and it closed above the previous candle high. That is known as trailing stop loss based on previous candle high and low. So this is where you book your profit. You shorted here this candle and you book your profit here. Then again downward movement started. Again look at this. Did any candle broken the previous candle high? No, right? No candle could break the previous candle high. Then finally, this is the candle closed above the previous candle high. So now you'll book your profit. Once you shorted here, then you booked your profit in this candle. Then if you again shorted either this candle or this candle, next you should have booked profit here. That is known as trailing stop loss based on previous candle high low method. You can see here this stock Tata Motors. You can see that entry was somewhere here, right? You kept your stop loss here. Then you kept your stop loss here. You kept stop loss here. You kept your stop loss. You can see that every candle went near the low of that candle, but could not break it. Could not break. Could not break. Could not break. Where it broke finally? This is the candle you broke. This is the candle broke, right? this candle broke the previous candle high. That is when you will exit the trade. That's it. That is what you can use the previous candle high low method. But remember, it should be used whenever the stock is in the strong downtrend or strong uptrend, not in the sideways market, not here and all. Okay. I discussed about the swing high low method, right? Swing high low means this is called swing lows, right? This is the swing lows. This is the swing. So now look at this. From here, market started going up. This is your swing low, right? It went, came down, went, came down, went, came down, went, came down, then started going up, then came down. Then finally, this is where you book your profit. Why you book your profit here? Because previous swing low was this, right? Previous swing low was broken, and this is where you book your profit. That's it. You can see that otherwise, from here, market started going up. This swing low could not break. This swing low could not break. This swing low could not break. Only wicks went below the previous swing. Look at this wicks. This candle could not break it, could not close it. So that means this swing is still valid. This swing could not break it. This also small swing. Then next swing was here, right? Then it started going up. But this swing has broken the previous swing, right? Previous swing broken, you book your profit here. That is what swing high, swing low method also can give you best way to trail your stop loss. You can see here again, swing low, swing low, swing low, swing low, swing low, swing low. Look at this. Just how much profit you can make just by following the swing low on the trending market, trending stocks, which are the uptrend or downtrend. Suppose you shorted here or here, look at this. Till here, you would have been still stayed in that trade, right? Because no swings could break the previous swing high. This was the swing high previous, next swing could not break it. This is the previous swing high. It went near the previous swing high, this candle, but could not break it. Next was this swing high. This went till here, could not break it. Next swing high is this one. Then next swing high was this one. Next swing high, this one, right? So still you would have stayed in that trade. But remember, this needs patience and discipline, and it can work for people who are into positional trading, who want to take the delivery and have patience to wait for months. For such people, you can use it. But if you are a just small swing trader for 3-4 days, 1 week, then this method may not work, because for that, swings will come. Sometimes it may come once in 2-3 months also. Like for example, last swing came in the month of mid-June. Next swing where it came in mid-September, right? So almost 3 months. After 3 months, you got the next swing. So that's why this is specially for trader who take long-term position, long-term kind of positional traders. Now moving average method. Moving average again here. 20 MA, you can use it. Okay, 20 MA, you can use it. I told you about that strategy, follow the trend strategy, but there you have to use 50 MA. Here you don't need 50 MA, you can just plot 20 MA. Once candle breaks above the 20 MA, if you entered here, if that stock is in the strong uptrend, look at this, it could not break the 20 MA. Here finally it broke the 20 MA. The moment it breaks the 20 MA, you are out. So in this stock, had you entered here around 450, 460, your exit would have been here around 760, 770. So look at this, how much profit you would have made. So look at this, how much profit you would have made around 450, 460 till 760, 770, right? Almost 300 points. So that is around three and a half months. You would have made such a big profit. Now you know that why I said swing trading, you can make a huge profit you can't even imagine, right? If you came from day trading and you're starting swing trading, sometimes you can make huge profit. But there is a disclaimer. And the disclaimer is, It will not happen that you take a trade and immediately it will start going in your direction and you make a huge profit every time in swing trading. No. For that, you need to have both patience and discipline. What I mean by that, that means if you have taken a trade, for example, you have taken this trade, you have taken a long entry here and you decided your stop loss is below that candle and you decided that you will take a long entry here, stop loss here, and market, instead of going up, it started coming down and started going down. Then what you will do? You will cut your position. You will close your position in a small loss. You will take your stop loss and you close your position. That is known as following the rule or following the discipline in trading. Okay, that means you decided your stop loss was here, your stop loss hit, you are out. But same time, if that trade goes in your direction, then you should not be in hurry to book your profit. That means you have decided that you will plot 20 EMA and you will trail your stop loss. That means you should have patience to wait till here. You have entered somewhere here. You should have patience to wait till here. Then only you can make some good profit in swing trading. Okay. Don't think that the moment you take it, it will keep going up every time. These strategies are like holy grail strategies. Every time it works, nothing like that. Okay, so that is what I said. Sometimes you can't even imagine you can make this kind of profit in swing trading. Look at this. How big is your profit, right? Your stop loss is small and look at your profit target. Somewhere here you have entered, right? Look at this. This is what risk reward. This is kind of risk reward you can get in swing trading. That is why I said profit can be very big in swing trading if trade goes in your direction. If your trade is right, then sometimes it can give a big move. Okay. Here also you can see that this stock is Hero Moto Corp. It started going up above the 20 EMA. Every time it came near the 20 EMA, it took the support. Every time it came near 20 EMA support. But this is where it broken the 20 EMA. You are out. This is where you should take your profit and close your position. It may happen that sometime it breaks that 20 EMA and again started going up. Don't worry about that. Now don't enter. Once it breaks 20 EMA, you are out. Okay. Now go for the some other stocks. Look for some other trending stocks. Once it breaks the 20 EMA, you are out. If VIX goes below 20 EMA, if VIX goes below 20 EMA, that doesn't matter. Candle should not close. If it closed, mean you are out. Now we are coming to the risk management. Coin toss exercise to understand risk management. What is this coin toss exercise? Let me tell you this. Risk management, one of the very, very important in trading. Okay. So strategy is not everything in trading. Risk management also equally important. Don't just think that strategy, if I have good strategy, I can make lot of money, lot of profits. I can only keep making money. That is not possible because strategies are not foolproof. Strategies are not foolproof. Strategies are not like 100% foolproof method that every time it works. Sometimes strategies can fail. Best to best patterns, best to best setup also can fail. So whenever it fails, you need to know how to manage the risk, how to control the risk. That's why risk management is very, very important in trading. Whether it's a day trading or swing trading, you need to know the importance of risk management. Don't take the trade until you understand the risk management. Power of risk management in trading. How to know the power of risk management? I will show you small exercise called coin toss exercise. When I realized the importance of risk management, even I have done this exercise. Okay, I personally done this exercise, and after this exercise only it came to my mind and I realized that how important is risk management in trading. So my advice to all of you, you should also do this exercise after this course. Once you watch this entire course, your next step should be this exercise called coin toss exercise. What actually you have to do here? Toss a coin 100 times and write down your result. Take a notepad, take a pen. Okay. Give some time. One and a half hours time. Keep yourself free to do this exercise. Write 1 to 100 on your notepad. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that 100 times. 1 to 100. And against every number, you should write whether it's a head or tail. You should toss literally 100 times. 100 times you have to toss one after another. After every toss, write down on your notepad. Is it a head or tail? Head or tail? That is what the exercise. Each time it falls head, it's a winning trade. Each time it falls tail, it's a losing trade. You know that when you do that, when you do a toss, it can fall either side. It can fall head or tail, right? One of the side, definitely it will fall. Whenever it falls head, in your notepad, write that win. Whenever it falls tail, write loss. That is what you just write down in your notepad. And you make one more column for writing the amount. Every time it falls head, you should write 10,000. That means you made 10,000 rupees. Just write down. Every time tail falls, write down as a 5,000. That means whenever it falls head, you will write 10,000 against that. Whenever it falls tail, you will write 5,000. Do this for 100 times. Okay? Do this and see your result. I have done this when I wanted to know this exercise to understand the risk management. My result was like this. 46 times it fell head, 54 times it fell tail. That means more than head, it fell tail. That means most of the time it was a losing trade. 54 times it was a losing trade, 46 times it was a winning trade. But since I was writing 10,000 every time it falls head, 5,000, after I did the calculation, you know what, how much profit I made? 1,90,000. Because every time it fell head, 10,000 into 46 times, 4,60,000. Every time it fell tail, only 5,000 rupees you were losing. Even though 54 times it fell tail, you lost, but still your loss was only this much. Even though 46 times only it fell head and you had a win, your profit was bigger. Why? Because whenever you win, you won 10,000 rupees. Whenever you lost only 5,000 rupees. And eventually, this was my net profit, 1,90,000. This is my profit, doesn't mean that it's a real profit, virtual money. That means I have written down on the notepad like a paper money, okay? Not a real money, just a paper money. I'm giving example just to see power of risk management. That means what? That means it will tell you that it doesn't matter in trading. 50 times your stop loss hits, still you don't have to worry in trading. What you should worry? You should worry about following the risk reward, which is minimum 1:2. I was following minimum risk reward of 1:2. That's why whenever it fell tail, I lost 5,000. Whenever it fell head, I made 10,000, which is 1:2 risk reward. And what is the win rate? Win rate is lesser than 50%. Out of 100, only 46 times it fell head, which was the winning trade. Less than 50%, but still I made money. How I made money? Because I followed the risk reward. That is why very important in trading. Whenever your trade doesn't work, cut off your losing position. Don't fight with the market. Don't do averaging. Just follow the discipline to cut your position, cut your losses quick. But whenever trade goes in your direction, minimum ensure that you follow 1:2 risk reward. And just remember, just by 1:2 risk reward only, this is the paper money, right? Virtual money I made. Instead of 1:2, if it was a 1:3 risk reward, it would have been bigger, right? That is the power of risk management. That is how professional traders make money in trading. Professional traders don't make money because they have some magic. They have some magic indicator. Only they know it. That's why they are making profit. No, they have good strategy. They have a strategy with an edge. High probability strategy. They enter at the discount whenever there is a strong uptrend. They don't chase the market. They follow right setup, right? They show the patience to enter at the right location. They follow everything and they follow the risk management rule. That is how professional traders makes money in trading. That is what you should also do in trading. Follow the risk management. Okay? Follow the risk reward. That means whenever you lose, your losses should be smaller. Whenever you make profit, it should be double of your loss. That is how one can make profit. So I highly recommend you to do this exercise called coin toss exercise after this course and see result for yourself. Now you should do another exercise, same coin toss exercise in the live market. Previous slide, what I shown that you can do it after market hours, but now you should do in the live market. What you should do? Apply this logic in the live market with a simulation method. What is the simulation method? Nothing but paper trading. Paper trading means doing the virtual trading, not with the real money, paper money. Okay, that is what my advice to all of you. If you are very new to swing trading, very new to trading, don't just jump into trading to make profit from the day one. First learn trading. That is how you can do the paper trading. Paper trading like a simulation, not the real money. Emotion may be different, but it will give you same kind of where you can enter, keep stop loss. It will show you MTM, everything it will show you, just like how you do the real trading. You can try this paper trading for a few days, okay, and see how is your result. Then only take up trading with the real money, with a small size. Where to do paper trading? You can do paper trading in three platforms. One is Sensible. Sensible is one of the platform. You can go to Google and you can type it and see. Sensible, you can do the paper trading in options. Okay. If you are an option trader, you can try this Sensible. Next one is Moneybuy. Moneybuy, especially for people who want to trade directly in the cash. If you want to trade in cash, then you can try it, Moneybuy. Trading, you also, you can do the paper trading. You can trade in future here. Okay, you can trade in futures in trading view. So these are the three platforms you can try, whichever you feel comfortable. But start with the paper trading. Don't start with the real money immediately. Get some experience, get some practice. What you should do, what is the goal of this exercise? Goal is to apply risk management rules. Trade like a machine without emotion. Your goal should be trade like a machine. Mean how you switch on a machine, it keeps working, right? Until you switch off. That is without emotion, nothing. Whenever you are doing trading also, you should trade without emotion. Just to follow these rules. That means, again, toss a coin. Each time head falls, go long. Okay? You can do the paper trading here, whatever I've shown you here. Don't have to do any strategies and all this, okay? This is, I'm saying, risk management. I'm not discussing strategies, which we discussed in the second session. Here you are not doing any strategies. Here you are only focusing on risk management. That means you just toss a coin. If it falls head, you will go long. Just punch buy order. If it falls tail, just punch a sell order. That means if it falls head, you will go long. If it falls tail, you will go short. And you ensure that your profit target is 4%. Stock loss is 2%. That means suppose you are trading in a stock, 200 rupees stocks. Okay, you are trading in 200 rupees stock in cash. What is the 4%? 208 rupees. What is the stop loss? 196. All right. This is just an example I am giving. If you are trading some 200 rupees stocks, what is the 4% of 200? 208. What is the 2% of 200? 196. You follow this method, which is risk reward of 1:2, and you don't follow any strategy. Just you focus on risk management. Just you follow the rule without any emotion. Do this for a few days and see the result. You will be surprised to see the result yourself. Even though you win 50% of the time, okay, if you win 50% of the time, you lose 50% of the time, still you see that you made a good percentage of profit, okay? Just calculate your percentage after maybe 100 trades. Just calculate how many times you made profit, how many times stop loss hit, and the percentage. And you will be surprised to see how powerful is the risk management. Okay. So this is what the exercise I can suggest you to do it after this in the live market for a few days. And since you are not doing the real money, you don't have to worry about the brokerage and all this, right? You are not paying any brokerage. It's a virtual trading, paper trading. Just follow the risk management and just see how is the result. Now we are discussing about the position sizing in swing trading. Why position sizing is very important? Because position sizing, you should know how many stocks you need to buy or sell. It is not based on your whims and fancy. It should be based on your capital. What's your capital? And what's your stop loss? That is what you will decide the position sizing. That means tomorrow you see XYZ stocks, it's in the strong uptrend. and you want it to buy whenever it comes near the 20 MA, and it came near the 20 MA. Now you are ready to buy, but how many should I buy? 100 shares, 200, 300, 500, how much? That is how position sizing will tell you that. Position sizing will tell you whether you have to buy 150, 200, 250, how much stocks, based on your trading capital and stop loss. That is what I'll show you in the next slide. Position sizing can help you to survive in trading game for longer period. Many people don't even survive in trading to learn trading. That's why I keep saying, even I say same thing in my day trading courses also, that first focus on survival in